watching Agenda, which is coming to you on the day where we heard the unearthing of a shocking story of sex abuse of children, which took place over a 12-year period. We will be speaking to the head chairperson of NCPCR, which looks after child rights. It's a government body. We also have somebody from Save the Children. But before that, we'll also be playing out Women and Child Development Minister Meneka Gandhi's interview about how she has been fighting to have a national register for sex offenders so that those who have been convicted, their names are made public so that people are careful. Remember, this particular case is of a tailor who's been apprehended here in the capital. And he says that he was caught once before in 2006. So how is it that for 12 years he was able to molest hundreds of children and no one was keeping an eye on him? First, let's just hear what he said.
Sunil, ye batao kitne saal se 9 se 10 saal ki bachchi ko tum target karte the, kaise karte the ye batao?
Main le jata tha isse.
Kahan le jate the?
Jinon pe.
Kitne saal se ye sab kar rahe ho bachcho ke saath?
4-5 saal.
Kyun karte the ye?
Pata nahi sab kya ho jata hai.
कितने कितने साल के बच्चे को तुमने अभी तक टारगेट किया है?
10-11 साल.
हाँ,
10-11 साल.
कहाँ कहाँ तुमने कर रखा है?
गाजियाबाद, दिल्ली.
That's what he's claiming, and the police now saying that they will be unearthing all the details about him in investigation. They say he's already confessed. But when NDTV spoke to Meneka Gandhi, she said that while she's been asking for a national registry on sex offenders for the last 2 years, it's got stuck because the MHA, Ministry of Home Affairs, hasn't moved on it. Here's what she said about why this is required, and also this happened on a day when her ministry was meeting to have an alliance on child abuse. Their idea, of course, is limited to online abuse, but here's what the minister said. Two very serious instances of child abuse have emerged from the capital and from Maharashtra. And to talk about the implications of both of them and how perhaps paedophilia can be countered by the government, we have with us Women and Child Development Minister Meneka Gandhi. Ma'am, thank you for joining us. Ma'am, these two very disturbing cases, which have taken everyone by surprise, actually come on a day when you're also talking about a national alliance against child abuse. I want you to explain that first. But ma'am, your initial thoughts, as we are only getting to learn and understand what took place in Delhi about this offender who has been apprehended, and also what was happening in Bid, Maharashtra.
Well, about 2 years ago, I had repeatedly said and asked for in writing that we need to have a national register of sexual offenders. And it's something that I brought up again today. Two things. One is that you have to have this register. And the second thing is, we have a lot, I'm digressing now, we have sexual offenders coming into India for sex tourism, especially against children, who have been convicted in their own countries. But we are the only country that doesn't ask you to write whether you've been convicted of any crime when asking for a visa.
We never asked that.
No. So we are asking for it now, that MEA put it into the visa form, that have you been convicted of any crime? Because we have to write on it when we go abroad. So why should we not ask for it as well?
That's a really good point. And because we've seen in recently, whether it was in Chennai and other parts as well, people getting convicted, foreigners who've been convicted for child
abuse.
No,
there was one a British Airlines pilot who used to come in here to molest children and then go back, and he'd been convicted of it at some point. I don't understand how he was allowed to get away for so long. But anyway, that's digressing. In the question of what has happened today, the tailor, the other teacher, who have, these are common people. I mean, what I mean by common people, I mean, is tailors, teachers, parents, mamas, relatives. These are the first finger of suspicion people. Because child abuse is extremely common. Mm. The two things come out of this. One is that the only way in which we can lessen child abuse is for the victim himself or herself to speak out. Now, since I became minister here, we have invented many new routes for them to speak. All any child that has to do, if they have been molested even once by anybody, is simply get onto a computer or ask an adult to get onto the computer under www.ncpcr.org. Just, it will open up. There comes out an e-box. They just have to write in, if they want to put their name, fine, otherwise not. And write the complaint, send it in about whom, and we follow it up. Now, in the last month, we've had 156 complaints. Each one has been dealt with. Some we've taken to the police.
Just in the last month, of children.
Of children.
Directly coming online.
That's
and reporting.
Right.
Wow.
So, but 156, again, in the larger context, is very little. But, I mean, 156.
So the government
children.
Could go in there and do an intervention through police.
That's
or
right.
whoever.
Yeah, through psychologists, police. Whatever. But the point is, the interventions have been done. Now, if we could have more victims speak out, because nobody can take any action if you don't complain.
Right, right. So ma'am, in this...
So, in one, yeah. This is one. Two, this tailor has apparently been caught before in 2006.
Right. Yes.
So, if he's been caught before, why is his name not on a national register of sexual offenders?
So this map, this national register, I know you've taken it up before. You've said 2 years before. So where does it lie now? Why hasn't it been done?
Because they keep saying that it's going to be part of a huge, I don't know the initials for it, but some kind of huge national register in which all crime will be registered.
But not a separate one for sexual offenders, which is the norm in many other countries across the world as well. So you're pursuing it.
Yes, we are pursuing it.
But it's the MHA which hasn't...
Which has to do it. Yes, because they're the ones with the statistics.
Is this something that across activists have a problem with as well?
No. Why should anybody have a problem with this?
So they're all...
It's really important to have one register with convicted sexual offenders. And I even say that have another one of where sexual offenders are on trial. So let's see.
Ma'am, the e-box thing, it's a great idea, and you're saying 156 children have already...
Just in the last 1 month.
Just in the last 1 month. Ma'am, what about in a place like Bid though? What are the immediate interventions that a child can seek? Because first of all, it's an authority figure. Most children would be confused about...
They have to complain. There's nothing... I can't dream about it. You know, I would say about 70% of children are molested from all classes. Rich, poor...
Yeah.
Because it's not even, you know, it's something that adults believe they can get away with. And a large portion of this is from people who already know you, related to you, neighbors of yours, teachers, and all of them are authority figures. But until the child finds a way to complain, and that is what we are making available to them.
And POSCO is strong enough?
It's very strong.
So there's no change. You don't think that it needs like a legal backup or anything like that. We already have a strong...
We have a very strong act, but we just need now the complaints. Now, if we can do it in 156 cases, I can do it in 156,000.
Right.
We also have Childline.
Yes.
If you don't want to, if you can't get through to the e-box, then you complain to Childline.
Which is just a phone number.
400,000 children complain every month.
Wow.
About different things.
In India.
Yes, to Childline. It's a magnificent system.
Yeah.
And... I started it in 1998, I think, when I was Minister for Social Justice.
Yeah.
And it's come back to me now.
Yes.
And you can complain there at 1098. Complain.
We'll... 1098. I think we are also going to send that message across, that Childline, e-box, two ways that children should really get it. And perhaps parents should talk to their children about these options.
And the third is that every school, if anybody's listening to this, to me speak now, for God's sake, get the film Komal, which is on YouTube.
Yes.
It's free. Get it and show it in the school for 1 minute so that children know what they can complain about.
There is an issue I know which is close to your heart. Everyone expects you to speak when it's an issue about animal rights. Jallikattu has been in the news, ma'am.
Not saying anything.
You're not saying anything
no,
about
it? No, it's over. The Supreme Court has already taken action. I don't believe that everybody should get into this, and I don't believe it should be made a political issue at all. Nor is it a matter of national pride or even state pride. It's just simply a matter of killing bulls and being mean to them. which is not part of Hinduism or part of the great Tamil culture, which is essentially a really educated, gentle culture. So people, everybody's trying to jump in on this bandwagon. Fading film stars who want people to see their films, politicians who want to capture the void left by Dr. Jayalalitha's death, people who want to be in the limelight. It's, you know, the wrong people are getting hold of this. It's a matter that has been, every side has been looked at by the Honorable Supreme Court. A reasoned and sensible judgment has been given.
So the minister, they're throwing an idea out of how the registry can help, how this alliance can help. Let's just get our panel in over here and our audience from the Bhagat Singh College. We have the chairperson of the NCPCR, Suti Kakkar. We have Prabhat Kumar of Save the Children. Ms. Kakkar, if I can just start with you. Ms. Gandhi, her views on having a national registry has been reported a lot, but why is it that something like this, which is prevalent abroad, why is it that the government hasn't moved on it?
Well, this is a subject which concerns many ministries, and it is important to have some kind of a database on all these sex offenders, especially in the case of children, and therefore we have to move towards it. And like this gentleman, he had been convicted earlier, but since we don't have an organized system, he got away with it. In between, he may know, there may not have been any complainant who complained of child sexual abuse, and therefore he kept on at it till he was finally nabbed. Today in the conference, again, we got a very valuable suggestion in which they said that even people coming from abroad must declare in their visa permission forms that they have never been convicted of such a crime, because India is fast emerging as a hotspot for child sex tourism, and therefore it's very important that we take steps regarding maintenance of a database.
Right. Okay, so Prabhat Kumar, how practical do you think this entire idea is of having this registry? Is that the solution that as an activist you're looking for?
That's of course one of the solutions that we are looking at. Like having the list of these offenders will be a good idea, and then if it works, then people can identify and take action. But we have to go a step further. What needs to be done, that this itself will not solve problem. Even if it comes to police, then only police will be able to register the things. How the things move from, like when a victim is being abused, how then things are moving, we have to see that. How the child welfare committees, the juvenile justice board, the entire framework on integrated child protection schemes work. So like our chairperson says, that it has to be a coordinated effort and it cannot be seen in isolation. This idea of the registry is a good idea. Only caution we need to take is that it has to be managed in such a way, in a country like India, it cannot be put in public. And these things have not worked elsewhere. Like there are examples where these things may not have worked very well. Here it can work.
No, but I thought the whole idea is that you make it public, that you say, many people are saying, and for instance in the US, that you say that a parent can log on and find out if there are any sex offenders in their area living there, and then they'll be wary, they'll look out for their children. That's not the idea you're saying.
Yeah, that's the idea, but that's a gradual idea. You cannot do it at first step. The first step ideally should be the register, maintaining a register that is accessible to police department, so that there is enough FIR, police is able to coordinate amongst themselves, then the law enforcement agency takes it forward. So whenever the victim...
So the first problem is putting it all out there.
All out there.
Just before we take more questions, Ms. Kakkar, I just wanted to ask you. So the minister was very clear, the MHA hasn't moved. Is it the fact that you said that you have to coordinate between so many ministries that nobody's moving on this?
No, it's not that, because this topic has been taken up by the ministry, and therefore the minister must be... spoken about MHA's action on it. But as far as NCPCR is concerned, this issue of child sexual abuse has been occupying us. And in fact, to my mind, it is the mother of all crimes. A child that gets abused, whether at home or outside, runs away from the house or, you know, gets emotionally scarred or something. And therefore, we have recommended also to all the schools and institutions that when you employ a person,
yes,
who is dealing with children, that person also should give a certificate that he's been never implicated in a child sexual abuse case. Because sexual abuse happens in the streets.
These are ideas which is coming across, and perhaps what's very
schools,
important, as you're also saying, which the minister also pointed out, that we have to teach our children about good and bad touch, because nobody can help you if the children isn't raising an alarm. So it's imperative for everyone watching to talk to their children about this, to make them aware so that they raise an alarm. Remember, this was happening, and only when the children, you know, somebody reported over here about the tailor who was taking them away on the ploy that they were saying that their parents were asking for them the clothes, only then did it come to light. So it's important that everyone speaks to them. I just want to take a couple of questions. Yeah, go ahead. What's your question?
My question is that we will talk, if we will treat them as a...
Yeah, that
if we will
they should be treated as a criminal.
No, they should not be treated as a criminal. They should require a good psychological treatment so that it can be cured out from our society, from the root. That
okay, yeah.
Actually, government should study about some laws in, like in United States and Canada, there are child protection and safety laws which was implemented in 2006. They also talk about pedophilia. Pedophilia is not at all a crime.
Actually, that's an interesting point. Do you think our laws, because the minister said that POSCO is strong enough, our laws are capable of tackling this?
I think POSCO, if you look at Protection of Children from Sexual Offences Act, is one of the progressive act. There are enough provisions within act for the penalty, for like making it child friendly in all sense. What needs to be done is make it more functional, like how the law enforcement agency are able to register properly, coordinate amongst themselves, how the community watchdog needs to work. And like you said, the most important thing is that if children know about good touch, bad touch, safe touch, unsafe touch,
yes,
then only they will be able to speak.
And what's the conviction rate? Because that's important as well.
If you look at the conviction rate currently is very low, but post 2013 the conviction rate is picking up. At least people reporting about sexual abuse have picked up, but the conviction rate still, like most of laws, are challenged, and that needs to be improved.
Okay, and then next question, yeah, go ahead.
Sir, what's your opinion about the conservatism of the Indian society? Is it responsible for this kind of situation? Like, people are not able to tell about this bad touch and good touch. Like, our parents, they are not so much open with it. So, do we need openness in this society?
Ms. Kakkar, so do you want to respond to this question?
Yeah. I would like to say one thing, that the POSCO Act is a very comprehensive act. It covers almost all situations. It talks of prevention, it talks of rehabilitation. A lot of programs have been taken up to spread awareness about good touch, bad touch and all that. But ultimately it comes back to also guiding the parents, teaching the parents. A lot of this CSA is taking place within families, which again is something which we need to tackle, and most important of all is to bring out this subject which is in the closet into an open kind of a discussion. People have to accept the fact that this is happening, and all of us as a community are responsible for our children. They are our children, they are not anybody else's
children. Exactly. And if there's one thing that the government can do to perhaps, you know, make this kind of reporting, that this person could have been caught before 12 years had passed, if there's a simple step, would it be, Prabhat Kumar?
I think the most important thing the government should have done, child protection should be seen as priority, like an investment and all, educating, creating awareness amongst children within a school, having that framework, making parents aware through these schemes, and then the law enforcement agency and protection agency, whenever they come into contact with anything like this, they should cater to needs of children or particularly victims.
Okay, that you heard it over there. And as we end this show, just to point out to people and anybody watching who may want to report something, that perhaps the easiest way, either you can go on to NCPCR and others and they have an e-box by which you're sending an online complaint. But if you don't have access to the internet, you can, of course, call Childline. And that's 1098, right? 1098 is the number to call if you want to report any kind of action, just fear something. And don't worry, it doesn't have to have proof or anything like that. It is sometimes intangible. That's what the experts pointed out as well. So make sure you report anything feels amiss. That's it on Agenda. Of course, this story of the crimes that this tailor was committing is just going to unravel in the coming days, and we'll keep reporting that. That's it on Agenda. Thanks to all my guests. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.